Yeah, what's the engine in there?
A bad one.
Diesel!
I already know what's up.
What can you say? It's a 6.6 Duramax, supercharged.
Yep, with the Whipple on it.
Damn, two tanks of f***ing nitrous, that's crazy.
This is LokJaw, and we're at the home of Hot Wheels, Mattel's headquarters in El Segundo, California. We're surrounded by like 750 of the world's most amazing cars. Judges are gonna go through this afternoon and decide which one will be the next toy in your collection.
Banks built, protected by AMSOIL, with support from Roaster Shop and Nitto.
What are you guys here to see?
Hot Wheels, dude, nothing but. I'm ready, let's go.
You ready?
I'm ready.
I'm ready.
I kind of want to play with LokJaw as a Hot Wheels car, so I kind of think that would be the way to go.
How much do you make it out for, dude?
About 650 before nitrous.
Before nitrous?
Yeah. And we'll do 150 shot of nitrous. Think of the engine.
It's really cool. Really, really cool. I like the craftsmanship on the headers, the stainless steel, the big Whipple.
I like those headers right there.
Yeah, yeah.
No, I didn't think it was going to be a Duramax. That's why it's awesome. It's so sick.
Must have taken a long time for the CNC to like cut all that stuff
out.
Yeah,
so sometimes you can buy blanks where it's obviously you got the wheel shape, but then you got a CNC out the center, but it came from one solid chunk and each one was about 22 hours.
Yeah, because usually you can just order like the stock wheel plate, right?
Exactly. Cool. About 22 hours of machining each wheel, he said.
And then the fender wells to perfectly complement the wheels look so nice. I mean, it's just such a nice presentation the way it's all put together. It's really beautiful stuff.
That thing's beautiful, bro.
You have to pick one thing on LokJaw that is your favorite feature. What is it?
I like the idea of NOS.
Considering it's a diesel truck, you don't normally see diesels running NOS, at least not on the street. So that setup is pretty awesome. I like all the carbon fiber, the NOS tank and the drive shaft.
You need to come down to Miami with this bad boy. Oh, for real, come on down to Miami, come hang out with us, all right?
Because this thing is a rust bucket externally, but internally you have all the details.
It revs up faster than most gasoline engines I've seen.
All of the welding, all of the billet pieces and everything, it's pretty rad under the really rough and crusty exterior.
Yeah, all the metal framing, custom framing work done on the back end, support the weight and the power of the motor. Must be a fun truck to drive.
Like I was telling him, I have every product bank makes for the L5P except for the boost tubes.
Freaking awesome!
I've never seen an intake that big. That's massive.
So far, I like the inner fender wells. I just like the tooling on them. All the looks handmade.
Wow, it just had no words. It's so beautiful. It's amazing.
Just thought, oh my God, just what I heard on the video, I wonder what it sounded like. I saw everybody plugging their ears, you know, in the shop.
It's unfortunate the fire marshal won't allow anyone to fire their cars in here, because if we could, I mean, it's unholy.
That was pretty cool.
That is a diesel!
Damn.
Right? Cool. My ears are still ringing. It's awesome.
It's definitely worth it. The winner of the 2022 Hot Wheels Legends Tour Stop in El Segundo is Mauro and Nora Zamudio and their gold 1969 Buick Riviera. Congratulations.
Yeah.
Would you like to say a few words, Mauro?
Just want to thank everybody who came out. It was a great event. I tried to make it last year and I couldn't, so I'm really happy I made it today. A lot of beautiful cars. I know it was tough to choose one, but I appreciate it. Thank you.
Well, LokJaw didn't win Hot Wheels Legends here in El Segundo today, but we know it's still number one in your heart.
It will be drivable in 2 weeks.
All right.
So stay tuned, guys. It's going to be drivable in 2 weeks.
All custom.
Thank you.
Like and subscribe to see LokJaw smoke some tires.